So I've been doing some spring cleaning in the office the last couple of weeks and months, and it's got me thinking the last couple of weeks about old things. And chief in this room that is me. I think I'm the oldest thing in here, and going to be turning 52 here in just a little while. And it's funny, I had a friend of mine back from middle school who turned 52, and I texted him, and I said, "Well, Don Stivic, it's good to see that you're finally playing with a full deck," because he's turning 52 as well. And the older I get, the more I realize that the things that I really cherish in terms of material possessions are some of the things that I've held on to the longest. And of course, those can't pale in, those pale in comparison to people. Obviously, I've been married to Pam for almost 30 years, and that's fantastic and wonderful. And our three kids are growing up. Our youngest just turned 22, so happy belated birthday, Anna. But as far as the material possessions go, some of those things that you just hang on to are just the things that, just by their nature, just get old with time. And they kind of grow up with you as you go along. And this is one of those things. This was the first kind of serious guitar I ever bought. And I think it was about 15, 20 years ago, somewhere around there. This is a Martin D15. And it is a mahogany guitar. It's made out of mahogany on the fretboard as well as the body. It's supposed to be solid top. I think it is. And this thing, and 20 years is not old by musical instrument standards or even just by regular standards. But by guitar standards, that's fairly old because we have a tendency to be a little rough on our instruments, as anybody who would play guitar would know. This thing has been kicked off its stand a couple of times. I'm not sure how many, but it's been more than a few. It's got a giant crack in the back, which is has had to be filled in, I think, as a result of one of those kickovers. Special shout out to Chris Lovell at Guitar Love, who's a luthier in the Hernando area and did a fantastic job fixing that up, and I appreciate it very much. You can tell that the fretboard now actually looks kind of shiny because of all the oils and stuff in your skin when you play it. It looks like it's made out of a different material than the body. It's not. That's just what's happened over time. And it's got nicks and scratches and all that over through it. You can see also that the back has been, like, the shine here is starting to wear as well. Or that's getting shiny for the same reason, because that's where your elbow kind of sits. But it is still one of the most mellow instruments I've ever played. It just makes you want to go take a nap when you play it. It's just absolutely, it's not as bright or flashy, as shiny as the Taylor that's sitting up there, but it is just one of my favorite instruments that I've ever heard or been privileged to own. And the song that has stuck with this guitar the longest is a hymn that I first heard at Christ Church Presbyterian in Watkinsville, Georgia, years ago, called "Great Is Thy Faithfulness." It's a hymn that stuck with me through the decades, and it talks about how, seasons in your life come and go, but God's mercies are new every morning, and they stick with you because God, who is of course older than any of us, who is seen it all, done it all. Is like this old thing, except much, much, much more so. Faithful and dependable, and is that's all I got to say about that. And when you record a song, I'm finding out that if you've watched that Liberty Mutual commercial and the guy keeps flubbing the lines, that's what recording a song is like, to try to get it exactly right. And the one take I actually got somewhat close to right, our dog had gave himself a solo right in the middle of the beginning of the second verse. So special shout out to Hank, who added something to the song. "Great Is Thy Faithfulness," on the Martin D15. Here it is. Enjoy.